And so let's begin with the Swarovski Elements Jewelry Award. So Swarovski Elements is the premium brand for the finest crystal elements manufactured by Swarovski together with their collection for its jewelry. Participants were required to develop a special project, present three sketches outlining a necklace, a bracelet, and a third component free of choice. The goal was to create new wearable pieces of crystal jewelry using Swarovski Elements. The Element Jewelry Award will grant the winner €10,000 and a six-month internship at the Swarovski headquarters in Wattin, Austria. To award this prize, I would love to call on stage Miss Ute Schumacher, Swarovski Trend and Designer Department Director.
We had a very interesting time with the finalists, and it was very challenging because it was difficult to compare, and every piece was really unique in itself. But finally, we found.
Okay. So I'd like to just explain the prize has been assigned to the finalists who combined a structured thinking process with a sense of platformness, distilled elements of craftsmanship from furniture working into innovative jewelry fittings and closure, merged the traditional mood and color of the Forbidden City with her own modern ideas. So, Ute, I think you wanna, this is for you. And so the winner of the Swarovski Element Jewelry Award is?
She is a woman, she is Chinese, she knows what she wants and she's very creative, and her name is Chao Si Zhang.
Congratulations. Thank you. I think you did a terrific job.
Thank you anyway, I'm so surprised now. I need to thank you. It's given me this incredible stage to show my work. And I need to thank you, Barbara, to let me involve this family. And, oh, sorry, I'm so...
You're touched.
Don't worry. It's normal.
Okay.
She's shaken up, but it's very normal.
Okay. I need to thank you, my darling, Naomi Mama helped me going here, and thank you, Diaries. Thank you, my master, Liu Hongbao. It's my Chinese tutor and my technician, Wang Bing. And thank you, my parents and at least. At last, thank you, myself. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you very much. And so let's begin with the Vogue Talent Award. Now, Vogue Talent, the section dedicated to talents of the website Vogue.it, is the media partner of It's 2012. The Vogue Talent Award consists in a photo shoot of the entire accessory collection of the winner by a Vogue.it photographer to be published in September, October 2012 on the Vogue Talent website. And Vogue assigns also the winner a press office, which is a real big deal, from July to December, and interview the winner for the website. To award this prize, I would love to call on stage Sara Maino, Senior Fashion Editor for Vogue Italia and Vogue Talent. Sara! The evil Sara! She's a piece of cake. Okay, so the winner of the Vogue Talent Award is...
Victoria Spruce.
Victoria, join us here on stage.
This is Sara.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
If you'd like to talk, yeah, this way it looks better.
Oh, wow, it's lots of lights.
Would you quickly like to thank anybody? You're going to kill me now, but...
Thank you to everyone. They know kind of who they are, I guess. But, yeah, thank you for everyone that's helped me and supported me and given me exposure. And it's been amazing. Thank you.
Congratulations and good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sara. You can go back to your seat. Okay, so YKK, an international group of companies with a leading position in the fastening industry that strongly believes in supporting creativity, allowed the launch of this It's accessory, the only competition in the world dedicated to all kinds of fashion accessories. Each designer enrolled in the competition was asked to include, together with their main collection, a design which made use of the fastening products supplied by any member of their companies. The winner will receive a cash prize of 10 10,000 euros. And to award this prize, we would love to call on stage fashion designer, he's my favorite, Kei Kagami, and the YKK Italy Managing Director, Marco Grandi.
Kei. Thank you for finalists. They worked very hard, and the standard of work, the highest ever.
Really?
Obviously, YKK people, including, of course, myself, yes. We are absolutely happy with the result.
Fantastic. Marco, vuoi aggiungere qualcosa? Would you like to add something?
Yes, thank you to all the finalists, but in the end, we decided to give the award to only one, but it was very difficult for us. But anyway, it's very important for us to help the creativity,
yes.
And to be together with this artist, I can say. So for the future, and also for our system, of the fashion system, is very important. I would like to give this award after when you...
Okay, so, motivazione. Now, the prize has been assigned to the finalists who presented a remarkably innovative collection using a new technique called fire lasting with the use of YKK's fire-resistant zip. Is that correct?
Okay.
Okay, spot on. So the winner of the YKK award is? Together?
Some note I read in his... note in my room this afternoon is a neat freak and will make you cry if you don't have clean nail.
Okay.
So I think I have my clean nail, so is Benjamin.
Benjamin.
Benjamin John Hall.
Benjamin.
Have you met Kay? Yes. So, highest expression of creativity using YKK this year?
Yes, thank you.
Impressive work. Would you like to thank anybody quickly?
Yes, I'd like to thank the jury, and I'd also just like to say that I really enjoyed working on this project, and with YKK, it was a pleasure to do the project, and also to be helped with by Kei Kagami.
Fantastic. So, good luck with everything. Thank you very much. Thank you, Kei. Thank you, Marco. And this is your prize. The winner of Accessory Collection of the Year will be awarded 8,000 euro towards the creation of a new accessory collection of at least 5 pieces, which will be presented to the press and public at the next edition of its. Deeply thank our sponsor, Modamon, for their support this year, enriching the money prize for this award and including a fantastic opportunity for the winner, who will be offered an exhibition of his creation at the next Modamon show in September. The evaluation criteria were creativity, innovation, and feasibility. To award this prize, we would like to call on stage last year's winner, Oliver Ruger. Oliver! Okay. So, motivazione. Now, the prize has been assigned to the finalists who presented a wholesome project which considered all the elements and accessory collections should have. The project stands on its own as a category. The quality of the realization was very, very high, right?
Very correct.
Okay, so the winner of Accessory Collection of the Year is?
I'm very happy to say, Anna Rajcevic.
Congratulations, Anna.
Thank you.
Would you like
I'm
to say
prepared
something?
For this.
You're not prepared?
Yeah, no, but I would love to thank first the crew in the corner, the people there, kisses, and jury, and yeah, you're a jury, okay, that's okay.
Yeah.
And I would love to thank my tutors, amazing Naomi Filmer, really, from the heart, Dairis, and El Komura, who's not here.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you very, very much, Anna. This is your prize. So take it away, baby. Thank you. And so, let's begin with the La Repubblica Award, the weekly insert of the newspaper La Repubblica, dealing with fashion, work, society, and culture, is media partner of its 2012, and will assign to a fashion finalist the Di La Repubblica Award, which will grant visibility to the winner on the magazine. So, I will be assigning this prize, and difficult name. The winner of the Dile Repubblica Award is Marius Janusauskas. Yeah? Marius! Congratulations. This is your award. You're good?
Yeah. Thank you very much. It means a lot to me. Thank you.
Okay. Very brief. Cool. Thank you, Marius. Let's move on to Modateca Award. The Anna Ferretti, a legend in knitwear, has decided to assign a prize of 3,000 euros to the most interesting knitwear collection. To award this prize, I would like to call on stage fashion writer Angelo Flaccavento, che dovrebbe essere qui. And so, the winner of the Modateca Award is?
Shengwei Wang.
Shengwei Wang! Hey, congratulations! I think you're going to have to hit the runway with your model. Thank you very much. You. Congratulations again. Grazie mille, Angelo. The completely new and celebrated musical La Febbre del Sabato Sera, Saturday Night Fever, will be at Teatro Nazionale in Milan. Opening night will be on the 18th of October 2012. The winner will have the chance to design the opening night costumes of the main characters, plus a 3,000 last minute cash prize that has been just added this evening. So, who are you?
Sergio.
Fantastic. Sergio?
Sono Sergio Zafferini, sono il marketing manager.
Okay, marketing manager. See, we didn't have this here, but fantastic, Sergio. So, you're good or evil? Evil?
I think both.
Yeah, definitely, absolutely. And so, the winner for La Febbre del Sabato Sera Saturday Night Fever Award is?
Isabel Vollrath.
Isabel! Congratulations! I think you're going to have to hit the runway. Go with her. And now let's move on to Vogue Talent Award, because the media partner of its Vogue Talent is assigning the award also to a fashion finalist who, just as the accessory winner, will be interviewed and receive a photo shoot of the entire collection to be published in September-October 2012 on the Vogue Talent website, together with the press office from July to December. Sara, credo tu non me ne abbia. I think I will assign this award, right? Urla? Sì, grazie. That means, yeah, you do it. Get on with it. Thank you very much. Okay, allora, a nome di Sara Maino di Vogue, I would like to announce the winner of Vogue Talent Award, Mark Goldenberg. Mark! Let's move on to Avery Dennison Brand Innovation Award. The winner of the Avery Dennison Brand Innovation Award will receive 3,000 euros and will also commission the winner to design and develop integrated branding solutions for their branding solution portfolio, published 2 times seasonally, and will feature in a dedicated It section for 12 months. For this collaboration, which will last around 2 weeks, Avery Dennison will pay the winning finalists an additional 2,000 euros. So to award this prize, I would like to call on stage the Global Creative Director of Avery Dennison, Mr. Fogele Downing. Fogele? Anyway, let's talk about the winner for the Avery Dennison Brand Innovation Award, who is?
Mark Goldenberg.
Wow, Mark!
Second one.
Two birds in two cages.
Okay, we'll then take them away. Thank you. Congratulations, Mark. Thank you very much. The fashion jury has assigned the next prize to the collection with the highest expression of creativity. The winner receives a cash prize of 5,000 euros, and to award this prize, I would like to call on stage the iconic, fantastic, unique Marina Abramovic. At this point, I'd like to say that the prize has been assigned to the finalist who, working with instinct, he created a unique and special connection of contemporary elements capturing the spirit of the time. Exasperating forms and volumes, sprayed, stained, alive colors, organic and solid materials. Now, the winner of Fashion Special Prize is...
Wait, I have to add a few more things. The guy really hates mainstream fashion, which is very important. He really hates mainstream fashion, he's rebellion, he's angry. And the winner is, Luke Brooks!
What? I'll give you the mic and say thanks to whoever you want to thank while you go through the catwalk with your model.
Oh, okay. I'd like to thank my grandma and my dad and my children for being patient.
The Diesel Award aims to ensure that fashion students' dream become a reality by offering them the most tangible way to support their breakthrough into the international fashion scene. The finalists were asked to work on a special project, and we have seen earlier in the evening the Diesel Fashion Show, presenting the finest culture interpretation of denim, couture interpretation of denim. The award consists on a cash prize of 25,000 euro that the winner can use without limitations to promote their work in the best possible way and to invest in their career. On top of that, the winner will be offered a 6 months internship at the Diesel Creative Team headquarters in Italy to discover all the secrets of working in a unique, innovative and international fashion environment. So, to award this prize, I would love to call the man himself, Renzo Rosso, here on stage.
Hi.
How are you?
Good evening. I am fine, like always. So, you want to say something?
I'd like to know, so what do you think of this 11th, you know?
So first of all, I'd like to say many thanks to Barbara because the 11th edition is really something unbelievable. I never saw something really very well done. The creativity this time is going over and over and it's becoming better and better. I think maybe we live in a particular moment, the crisis, the political situation, the world situation makes our young creative more motivated. It's a good moment. It's a good moment for you guys to take off your burn, your energy, and do something very particular. And I am very satisfied with what I saw here tonight. I think it's really the most exciting exhibition that we have done here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Diesel Award is?
It's Marius from Janusauskas. Okay. Okay. From Lithuania, in any case.
I think this is, you want to say hello to Renzo? This is your prize? Congratulations. Thank you very much, Renzo. I think you can take it away. Would you like to thank somebody first?
Definitely. I'd like to thank Diesel. I'd like to thank its family and Barbara, especially to you. Thank you.
And can I ask you, how do I pronounce your name?
Janusauskas. Janusauskas.
Of course, it was easy. Janusauskas. Thank you very much. And now, to award the next prize, I would love to call on stage the person who created this from scrap and with her fantastic team. Please join me here on stage, Barbara Franchin. You've got to be evil.
I'm good on Monday and evil in the other days. Okay. Thanks, Barbara, for your help. Thanks to all the staff of ITZ. Tonight, Trieste is very young. It's a global village. And the magic comes true once more. And thanks to Victoria. Come back next year.
Did you call me Victor?
Victor.
Okay, thank you.
Ciao.
Victoria. Grazie. Ciao. Grazie mille, Roberto. And so the prize has been assigned to the finalist who demonstrated an incredible level of commitment to his vision of 3D.